12 of you walked on the earth together. The Father was a brother to you all. The teaching that you heard was the living word.
Hello everybody, I'm Gladys Mukami and this is Champions Awake. Welcome to the program. And let's begin with a word of prayer. Our Father and our God, we thank you for this opportunity to share your word. We ask you that you may speak to us and through us. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray, believe, and receive. Amen. Our subject today will be expounding on the title of Champions Awake. With me here is Pastor Daniel Ngure, who is going to share insights on the word of God. Welcome, Pastor Daniel.
Thank you.
Yes. I will be sharing on the ways of awakening a champion. And I believe you'll be blessed. Let me start by reading some scriptures in the book of Luke 22, verse 39 to 46. And he came out and went, as was his habit, to the Mount of Olives, and the disciples also followed him. And when he came to the place, he said to them, "Pray that you may not at all enter into temptations." And he withdrew from them about a stone's throw and knelt down and prayed, saying, "Father, if you are willing, remove this cup from me. Yet not my will, but always your will be done." And there appeared to him an angel from heaven, strengthening him in spirit. And being in agony of mind, he prayed all more earnestly and intently. And his sweat became like great clots of blood dropping down upon the ground. And when he had got up from prayer, he came to the disciples and found them sleeping from grief. And he said to them, "Why do you sleep? Get up and pray that you may not enter into temptations." Now, the reason I'm reading this verse is because as champions, we learn from the Lord Jesus Christ that it was his habit to go to Mount Olives and pray. And we see that mostly he prayed, and even prayed throughout the night. And as a champion, it's very important for us to find a place of prayer for us in this life. I pray that we'll be able to take that as a challenge for us to really find a place of prayer. Just like Jesus, he had already gotten Mount Olives. And I would like to ask Pastor Daniel to share with us on the insights on Champions Awake. And I've talked a bit about finding a place of prayer just like Jesus Christ. Maybe you can add something to that.
Okay. Again, I'm glad to be on the show. Thank you for tuning in. I'd say why first she is taking us in that direction of prayer is because everything God does in your life as an individual must be done through your conscious involvement, conscious participation. In other words, even though God has a plan for you, he wants you to be awake to it. There is nothing God does that he imposes on you. I'm reminded of Ephesians 5 and verse 14, where he says, "Therefore he says, awake you that is sleeping and rise from the dead, and Christ will give you light." So there's an aspect of awaking. There's an aspect of being conscious. You must become conscious of what it is God is doing and God intends to do in your life so that you can actively participate. So I think, you know, prayer awakens us to several things. There is an awakening through your contact with God to your identity. So as you pray, there is an identity God reveals to you that is his will for your life. Romans 8 from verse 29, he says, "For whom he did foreknow, he also did predestinate." So beginning with the fact that God has foreknown your existence, existence. Your existence at this point in time is not an accident. You are foreknown by God. And because he foreknew you, he says you are also predestinated. In other words, your destiny is set. But that destiny is not something that happens automatically in your life. It is something that you must choose. It is something you must respond to, because probably having been born wherever you've been born or whatever situation you're in right now, you could have already chosen your own way. The prophet says in Isaiah that we like sheep have gone astray. Everyone has chosen his own way. So the fact that there is a set destiny doesn't mean it's automatically happening in your life. We are talking about prayer. We are awaking in prayer because he goes on to mention in verse 30, where we're reading from Romans 8, he says, moreover, whom he did predestinate, them he also called. So God gives you a call to your set destiny. And that call is because you are awake. That call is because you have come to a place where you are seeking, where you are looking not just to exist, where you're looking not just to go through the motions of life, but to be aware of the fact that you're here on earth, you are a product of God's foreknowledge and God's predestination. So he says he calls you to that, so you must respond. And as you respond to that, he goes on to say, those he did call, he also did, he says, he also justified. So now, because in prayer you are awakening to that call, God begins to mold that identity, that destiny that he has for you. We've said this awakening is an awakening to an identity you are getting through what God reveals to you. And this identity is really what molds your individuality as a person. So the justification process is the fact that God is molding that destiny, and you are beginning to take the shape of that destiny such that in your own choices, if there is anything that has become a part of your life that is not a part of God's destiny for you, then he can begin to change. He mentions, this is Matthew 15:13, that whatever plant my Father has not planted will be uprooted. And that's what he's doing through the justification process. And finally says, those he justified, he also glorified. Because in God, your destiny is glorious. So we are awakening to that destiny that is glorious, that allows the perfect will of God to be done.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor Daniel, for that expounding on that. And you know, when I was reading Luke 22, verse 45 to 46, when Jesus got up from prayer, and when he came to the disciples and found them sleeping from grief, he said to them, "Why do you sleep? Get up and pray that you may not enter into temptations." And you find that Jesus had foresaw that there is a lot of temptation and offenses. And he could see that the biggest issue that they were facing right there is sleep. So calling champions to awake to prayers and recognize their identity is very important, because sleep is one of the biggest causes of prayerlessness. And as a champion, we will need to overcome sleep and really pray. And we can even ask ourselves, How many times do we ever maybe started praying or even studying the Bible and you find yourself sleeping? It is very important us to know that when we draw closer to God, he draws closer to us. That's what the Bible says. And you find that prayer is one way that draws us closer to God. And you find that when you draw closer to him, we are able to receive all that. Like the part of identity requires us, we draw closer to God so that now we get to hear from him. We get to know him. So I really encourage us to really awake as champions, to awake to prayers. And thank you, Pastor Daniel. You can continue sharing on what you have for us.
Well, I think too, now that we are talking about drawing closer to God, he mentions, draw close to God and he will draw close to you. So as you begin to, come to where you are, willing to make contact with God, even in prayer, like we're mentioning, these things that we are talking about, for example, now moving to that place where God can strengthen you, God can begin to manifest his workings in you. Because that's the second thing, really, any champion should awaken to God's workings living in you. Let me mention something from 1 Corinthians 15. And as we get there, your identity is developed by God's working in you. This is not something that's humanly possible. Even Jesus mentions, I of myself can do nothing. It is the Father that works in me. So he mentioned something. This is 1 Corinthians 15 and verse 10. He says, but by the grace of God, I am what I am. So this is an example of someone that has awakened to their set destiny. Now, Paul, like we know him, had a history of being a persecutor, an injurious person. In other words, he had chosen his own way. He had been born into a system. He'd been born and he'd been brought up to be something that was not God's set destiny for him. He mentions how he was a son of a Pharisee. He had been brought up to be a Pharisee. For all of us, the awakening begins that contact you make with Christ. So now he says, I am what I am. He says, but by the grace of God, I am what I am. And this grace which was bestowed upon me was not in vain, but I labored more abundantly than they all, yet not I, but the grace of God which was with me. So as a champion, you begin to, through your identity, through making contact with Christ, coming to this place where you are embracing your set destiny, you begin to see God work in you, then your life will not just be full of activity, it will be activity that is blessed of God, that brings fruit for God, that glorifies God. How are you to go and bring forth fruit, and your fruit shall remain? So this is really part of what we are talking about, getting closer to God. As in prayer, that connection with your identity, that awakening to God's working, it's really something working together to fulfill what is God's will for you, fruitfulness in a manner that glorifies God.
Amen. That's so great. And, you know, I'm still thinking of when Jesus had gone with Peter and the rest of the disciples to the Mount Olive. He had gone there for them to pray together with him.
Yes.
But you find that for them, they were overcome by sleep and slept. Yes. And there is something that really struck me in that book of Matthew, chapter 26, verse 40, that when he came to the disciples and found them sleeping, he said to Peter, what? Are you so utterly unable to stay awake and keep watch with me for 1 hour? You see, the Lord was even asking for an hour. And that is, you see, Jesus himself asking for an hour, it is something that is showing that he really need more time with us. And he really wants us to spend time with him. And I was asking myself, how much time do we really spend in prayers? That's something I wanted to ask, because at times we find ourselves spending 5 minutes in prayer or 20, 30 minutes. And how many times or how many minutes do we pray? And as a champion, we must make a clear decision to be people of prayer. You know, Jesus asking for 1 hour, we can even go to 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours, even the whole night. Jesus spent the whole night in prayers. And that's the book of Luke 6:12 that says that in those days, it occurred that when he went up to the mountain to pray, he spent the whole night in prayer to God. So it is very important for us as champions to really cultivate that the Lord wants to spend time with us. So we are going to take a short break and we'll be right back.
12 of you walked on the earth together. The Father was a brother to you all. The teaching that you heard was the living word.